Battlespace Edge, it also reduces the data bandwidth and storage requirements. Now, this construct was demonstrated for the first time in the U.S. this past winter, when the Air Force allowed an AI co-pilot to control the sensor and navigation systems on a U-2 surveillance plane with no pilot override. Cognitive electronic warfare capabilities for tasks such as spectrum sharing, management, link adaptation, electronic attack are another promising area. Applying AI in this realm provides the ability to execute optimal strategies and adapt to a changing environment at machine speed. This could be a real advantage. Now, the second area is unmanned systems. These are likely to see greater AI-enabled autonomy moving up the value chain of what have traditionally been human taskings. For example, remotely piloted aircraft will unlikely be able to maintain secure communications with their ground control stations in contested environments. To address this limitation, AI-enabled UAVs can detect threats and other changes in the operating environment, and then use their AI algorithms to decide on appropriate actions when they're cut off from their human operators. Taking this one step further, the United States is actively working to develop what's called loyal wingmen UAVs through initiatives such as the Air Force's Skyborg Vanguard program and the Defense Advanced Research Project Agency's Air Combat Evolution effort. Teamed with manned aircraft, a human pilot can give general inputs and guidance to a swarm of UAVs and be confident that the swarm will behave as required. Absent AI-enabled autonomy, a single operator would simply not be able to manage that many platforms. Now, the emerging family of AI-enabled aircraft could fulfill a range of missions in support of advanced fighters and other manned aircraft. For example, they could act as an off-board sensor or provide additional ordnance capacity for manned aircraft. Autonomous aircraft could additionally conduct electronic warfare activities or serve as a communications gateway for the kind of camp combat cloud concepts of operation that are now proliferating. This last example points to a third natural application for AI, and that's command and control. The reality is, legacy command and control, or C2 systems currently in use, were not designed for the speed and complexity that information age, all domain operators, demand.